Good evening. Surgeons at the Alfred are deciding whether to operate on the Premier's fractured spine. Daniel Andrews is said to be in good spirits, but will likely be out of action for weeks. Mark Santamartino has the latest.
He was brought to the Alfred as a precaution, only for scans to confirm the worst. The Premier's damaged vertebrae is in fact fractured.
It can cause pain, it can cause immobility, and I would expect the pain to last perhaps 3, if not 6 months.
Daniel Andrews was leaving a rented holiday home on the Mornington Peninsula yesterday when he slipped on wet stairs. The Premier landed on his back, damaging the critical T7 vertebrae in the middle of his spine, breaking ribs on either side. An injury surgeon John Cunningham sees every day.
These fractures can be really common and often caused by fairly minor trauma, but the pain from them can persist for quite some time. Fortunately, they don't all end up in paraplegia.
Wife Kath left to be by the Premier's side this morning as surgeons debated whether to operate.
I know he's in good spirits. Kath and the kids are absolutely feeling well supported and are very thankful. He is in the very best of hands.
The Premier hasn't yet responded to the Prime Minister's text.
I haven't heard back from Dan, but I imagine he's been a bit busy. But I wish him all the best. I hope he's very well. You know, Dan and I get on very well.
Colleagues throwing their weight behind Dan's deputy.
James Molino is a consummate politician and he's doing a fantastic job as acting Premier.
With a decision on rebooting hotel quarantine and the May budget looming large.
That work will continue whether the Premier's there or not, but I very much hope that he's back for all of that.
Look, you put politics aside at a time like this, you don't like to see anybody going through that sort of pain.
I would expect him to find it uncomfortable to stand for long periods for at least another 6 weeks.
Now, Mark, can you tell us, have doctors decided to operate?
Unfortunately, there's no official word as we go to air, Pete. We were expecting a statement from the Premier's office. That hasn't come to light, but we do understand that doctors are considering an invasive procedure where they would use pins and plates to try and stabilise that region of the Premier's back. Even if they opt against surgery, he's facing weeks in a brace as well as on painkillers. So he's facing a lengthy stint on the sidelines to come, Pete.